Well, the sun's setting, people are vomiting, and the St. John's ambulance crew is busier than ever, but there's more to this show than just stomach contents. Dave Angel, the son of a great jazz musician, a great dance innovator with his music, has just put the finishing touches to his project, X Mix 4, a collection of tough tunes set to new age computer graphics. The guy's DJing down here, so we thought what a great time to catch up with Dave Angel.
It's an honour, really, to be there again. You know, I was there, like, last year. I've been at all the Universe raves, so it's kind of like... Yeah, it feels good. There's a few tracks that I've gone to the cutting plant to press, like, specifically for this Tribal Gathering, you know, which is, like, new tracks from my new EP on Ireland. The X Mix 4 project was, I really don't know how I came about to do it, you know. I think it was just maybe because I'm, like, DJing in Europe quite a lot, and maybe they like the style of my DJing, you know, and said, well, you know, would you like to do it, Dave? First of all, I done the mix, and then, like, gave the DAT to the German guys. They took it off, broke down the track separately, singly, and gave it to each video artist to make his video. And then it's got to be mixed together, just like how my records were mixed together, by another jock to put them all together in sync with the music. What I've tried to capture, really, is, you know, it's kind of like for clubbers, but obviously clubbers are gonna like play it when they come home from a club or something like that to wind down, you know? So I didn't want it to be the same kind of stuff that you're hearing in a club. I want it to be more musical, more relaxing. From my dad, really, you know. I mean, I can remember being a kid, you know, and like all my mates outside playing and stuff, and I wanted to listen to music, you know, and learn more about it and just talk to him and his friends. I was a drummer first from a young age, from like 8 years old, you know, and my dad bought me a drum set. You know, I was always bashing around on drums and stuff, and you know, in school, it was always music, you know, I was like on stage by myself and that, just playing drums, you know, and it was kind of, I don't know, you know, when I like saw two decks in motion, first of all, it was kind of like, wow, I'd love to do that, you know, but then it wasn't even 12-10s, you know, without pitch control and stuff like that. Most of the records were made at like the same speed, so you could mix them together anyway. If you were good, that was, you know, but then I wasn't any good at mixing at all, you know. I set rotation up about 2 years ago because of, you know, there wasn't many labels that was putting out the music that I wanted to hear, you know, across, like, England, say. You know, it was all coming out of Holland, coming out of Belgium, Germany, and America, obviously, you know, but, you know, there was a very few labels that was really making music that I wanted to hear, you know, so I thought, well, you know, I've got my studio, I've got friends who's producers as well, you know, I know lots of producers, let's get this label on the road. I'm really dedicated in my music, you know, and it's my life, really, you know. It's not second place. This is like, this is me, you know. And what you see is what you get, you know. That's it.
Time for the select.
I'm DJ Cole Cox. I'm right here in Oxford, Tribal Gathering. What a party. These people are kicking up some serious grass here. Check them out. BPM Tribal Gathering.
This actual rave here, it's like the old times, because it's got the vibe, you know what I mean? But things have changed, yeah. I'm spinning a mixture, really. A mixture of jungle, drum and bass, hard step, you know, mix and blend. All the top DJs on this jungle scene, none of us are big-headed, none of us are going around saying we're badder than him or he's badder than we. We're all the same, we're all doing one thing, we're promoting this new music that's hit this country. That's what we're doing. At the moment, I'm trying to make music to satisfy the punters. But as I learn more about making music, I'll obviously be making music to satisfy me. I still play everyone else's tune. Sometimes I kind of lay back on my own stuff, but sometimes when it's the right tune, then like the recent one I've done is Everyman, and that's been going down all right. But, you know, I haven't had much success before that, you know what I mean, on the producing side of things. Abroad, they're just following where they're, like, about a few years behind. And basically, they're just copying everything we've done, basically, because they want to have their own rave scene over there. But in Canada now, they're starting to make music over there. And in Germany, they've made a few jungle tracks in Germany as well. And, like, they are very keen to, like, get involved, you know what I mean? So, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter where you come from or who you are. Just, if you like the music, just make it. If you can make it, make it.
I'm gonna do it.
You're too. Whizzing round Tribal Gathering, and that's where you're going now.
Get out to all the ladies in the place. I want to see you move, your buddy. Get out to Sister Maisie in the crowd.
I did think it'd be absolutely fantastic. Everywhere you go, it's people smiling, having a really good time, checking out, you know, people who may not be in the jungle are in there listening to it and enjoying it. People who may not be into techno from the jungle scene are coming in and enjoying it. And I think this is really important for this sort of scene to survive. And after all, you know, a big party at the end of the day is getting everybody together to have a really good time. Music I like to think that I play, apart from maybe one or two hit records, is dead underground and records that I have to go and find from all over the world just to play at this one place where people can hear really good music. So, you know, I try not to categorise anything, but today was a very good example of what's really going on out there, as well as the stuff which has been hyped lately and through the media. I think the scene in this country has always been very, very healthy. I mean, if you think about the majority of the American DJs, most of them are residing now in the UK because the English crowds are so receptive to other people making good music. But then we shouldn't forget ourselves. I mean, it's fantastic DJs here, some brilliant producers, and there's some loads of party people. So really, I mean, this is kind of groundbreaking as respect that the UK can still kick a big rave or a big party. And really, it's just you know, probably one of its kind for a long time. And really, this is the way it should have gone without all the bullshit that we've had in between with the criminal justice bill trying to stop all these sort of things happening, because it is a very safe, legal and a happy event, and people do want this.
All you have to do is ride that bass. Get on it. you have to do is ride that bass. Get on it.
Taking their name from that dreadful stretch of road that surrounds London, Orbital have transformed themselves from Seven Oaks bedroom boys to credible album sellers. Proof positive that electronic dance music can go beyond anonymous one-off singles. And as they're headlining here today at Tribal Gathering 95, we thought we'd reel them in for a chat.
Friday morning we came down here, set up our gear and sound checked and everything yesterday. But the rest of our crew, like we've got a couple of video artists and the lighting guy, came down here on Thursday morning, set up our video projectors and make sure. But they were working last night, well, this morning till 6 o'clock, still finishing it all off.
The only sort of reluctance that we had about doing this gig was just because so many sort of, you know, there's so many big dance parties organised, and then so many of them fall through. We didn't really want to sort of put our name to something that, you know, a few thousand people have got tickets and paid £25 and then can't get their money back and that sort of thing. So we were just sort of wanted to make sure that it was definitely going to happen and everyone was, you know, and everybody organising it was genuine and, they, you know, they are.
Really, this was too early for us to come out and play because we were supposed to be doing new tracks and stuff like that, really. But we just couldn't resist it, really. So, but as soon as we finish this, we're going back in our little room and doing some new music, hopefully. There's no special routine that we go through, is there?
Well, there is for me. I tend to sort of
go to the toilet.
I won't drink anything for about 4 hours before because I always want to go to the toilet when I'm on stage. If
I've
got
a weak bladder.
So, well, it's sort of probably fear of 6,000 people staring at you.
Yeah.
You sort of grow up in a house together from, you know, day one for me, you know, sort of year four for him. And so sort of working together 5 days a week doesn't seem that much different from sharing a house like you did when, you know, when you were growing up. I just never really noticed it, you know what I mean? I still think I don't see him very often. I sit there and actually think, oh, I don't see my brother very often. No, well, you see him 5 days a week, all day long, but because I don't see him of an evening, I think I'm not seeing him, which is ridiculous. Started making music, it was just, you know, we made what we wanted to hear and, you know, we couldn't get a record deal, etc, etc. But, you know, for me, just because you've got a record deal, you know, I can only make the music I want to hear. I'm never going to get caught up in that thing of, oh, but our last record did this well, so our next record's got to do better than that. You know, I'm just not interested in that. To have your hobby turn into a career and to be able to sort of, you know, earn your daily crust from it, but as long as you can do that, I'm not really interested in making huge hits to, you know, buy huge Rolls Royces and things. That's not really why I do it. I do it because I like it. It's just, you know, perfect to be in that position.
Yeah.
Hello and welcome to the second of our fabulous specials, Tribal Gathering 95. Tribes certainly have gathered around us, that's for sure. We're in Beckley near Oxford and the toilet facilities are immaculate.
They certainly are.
It's a good job as well because like last week we were speaking to the DJs and the acts, the Gracely's five tents and the gig is still huge.
It sure is. There are hundreds of acts down here and 27,000 revelers. And I think it's time now to see what's on tonight's show. We party on with the Prodigy, underground heroes to a man. We've the life and times of DJ Billy Nasty. We reveal the secret identity of superhero Plastic Man. The drum club talk up their rhythm method and Sunscreen give us chapter and verse.
But right now, let's get under canvas and check out some serious body action.
It's our future. Yeah! It's our future. 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 It's our future.
I don't think they do. We'll be right back.
One of the country's busier DJs deserving of your attention is Billy Nasty, who bought his first decks age 16 and now 10 years later is at the top of his profession. Apart from his progressive sets, Billy has a little vinyl flair solo project on the go. And there was plenty to talk about as we intercepted him here at Tribal Gathering 95.
At the moment, there's nowhere I really kind of resident and kind of play every week, so I kind of travel quite a bit. My favourite clubs at the moment in London are kind of Ministry of Sound, UK Final Frontier on Friday, Strut at the Cross on Sunday is a really nice kind of social one. But there's also clubs like Voodoo in Liverpool and Temple of Sound in Dublin, you know, Matzo in Amsterdam. You know, I've got my kind of favourite clubs that I kind of seem to get to like once every 3 months or so. As far as records go, I just listen to as much as I can and just take whatever I like. It's like kind of a mixed mash of different styles and that. Although, you know, I'm big on kind of like, I'm into a lot of the kind of German kind of acid tunes that are not too hard but slightly more melodic. I first started getting in the studio about 3 years ago. Me and a friend, Paul Daly from Leftfield, he kind of helped me remix Join Our Club for Sinead, and that was the first thing we do. Since that, I've been kind of doing things under the name of Shiitake with Dave Wesson, who runs Zoom Records, and Steve Dubb, and Vinyl Blair with me and Steve Dubb. I'd like to finish the EP off and stuff like that. Me and my partner Steve Dubb, we've been buying equipment and setting up a studio in my house. I'd like to kind of find a commercial space for it and put it in there and start kind of working properly, and then trying to do like 3-4 days a week, like the Monday, Tuesday and Wednesdays or Thursdays, and then like starting the weekend DJ, try and get in the studio and get as much work done as possible. I do play music that I make out, you know, that's ideally why we make it. As it stands, most of the stuff I play is other people's stuff, do you know what I mean? And I think, you know, I'm kind of working on the studio side of it and it's like, it's coming together, but at the moment I'm kind of more kind of satisfied with my DJing side of it, and I'm still kind of learning my trade in the studio. Pew, 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 pew.
your feet up. Here comes the BPM selection.
Thank you. across River Jordan.
Party crew in the place, do you like the sound of your DJ? Do you like the sound of your DJ? You're in tune to the sound of Carl Cox.
Wicked, man. Don't stop, stop. Don't stop.
Whistle crew, bring on the noise for your DJ, Carl Carr. Take it away.
I mean, has the club always been in Dalston?
No, we've been here 5 years in February. Before that, we did the rounds of kicking down warehouse doors every week. And then we decided for a little bit of consistency, and we've been here ever since, Friday and Saturday night, and we love it.
Talking of Friday and Saturday night, what's the difference between the two nights, Sue?